Hey guys, we have Wild West Garden Silverado in the shop, and this one's special because it's high mileage, and not just ordinary high mileage, quite high. It's over 800,000 kilometers, and today we're doing an update. Okay, let's check out the odometer, and I'm really impressed with the condition of this truck. It's well taken care of. It is a work truck, but everything works in it. So you see it's 866,259 kilometers. Very impressive for how this engine sounds, how the interior is holding up. Now, a lot of these trucks with the digital controls that have more of the buttons over here, they typically wear out as far as the paint goes. The nice I've noticed here is on the work trucks, it's just full plastic. It doesn't wear nearly as bad. Now, I don't know if this piece has been changed out. That's very possible, but everything's held up well. The gauge cluster, it's original. The engine's original. The transmission's original. Typically, on parts like this that get used a lot, you'll have lights burnt out, but this one doesn't seem to suffer from any of that. So before we get into the mods, let's go ahead and check out the truck more. Now, we did note that the truck has rust on this side but not the other, so the owner thinks that some debris got on the one side. They're going to do some repair, but you know, this is typical of a vehicle of this age, especially one that sees a lot of salt. And we see the frame, there is some scale, but it's held up really well over time. Okay, let's go ahead and listen to the engine, because this is the part that I really like. So the owner has reported to me the only thing that's been changed are injectors on this vehicle, and the nice thing about these pushrod engines with multi-point fuel injection with the injectors up top, you remove the cover and you can get at the fuel rails. If it was direct injection, it might be more of a challenge to get at them, but you can see there's a testament to old pushrod V8s like this. You can see everything's easy to get at. So today's job, we are changing out the head unit and we're adding a backup camera. So the cool thing about this one is we're adding a tailgate camera, so we get a brand new bezel and we get to maintain the factory handle and key lock. It all comes out the bottom of the tailgate, so it's like it's having a factory setup without having to buy all the OEM parts, and this wasn't available on a work truck, so it's a nice little upgrade. So we're about to run our aftermarket wire along the frame, but what I like to do is I like to put dielectric grease into the plug and then surround it with shrink tube afterwards. That way I know I have a good connection. It's going to last a really long time. Okay, we're now in the interior, so frame looks good. Things under the truck is what you'd expect on a truck with high mileage. Also in the interior, things that have gone, this is normal, like with the material on the steering wheel, it lets loose of the metal, but otherwise, I'm actually really impressed how it turns out over time, because the owner actually is smart, and what he does is when he touches the controls, he stays off the painted surfaces. Those of you know that have the other style, the auto climate controls, the little buttons always get worn out because they're so small, you always have to touch the paint. This one, he avoids it, and look, it still looks the same. Like, it looks worn out, but it doesn't look nearly that bad. Like, this truck has over 860,000 kilometers on it, and everything feels good. So let's go over to how we modified the vehicle to make it more user-friendly. So the truck didn't have a backup camera before. Now it does. And we also have vehicle information. So we have vacuum, transmission temperature. Now you can access transmission temperature and the gauges, but you have to cycle through it. We also have engine load and voltage. We don't have a voltmeter anymore on the gauge cluster. This is the base model, so you don't get that gauge. The higher models you do. So we have a lot of new features that even a lot of factory head units don't supply you. So that's why I like having aftermarket, especially in a vehicle like this. Again, here it's separate, so as a modular system, decks, you know, truck's old, deck's old, we want a major upgrade, no problem. We only change out this part, and we can use whatever brand we want because it's aftermarket friendly. You're not limited to X amount of brands or manufacturer only because you have to only use that piece. We don't have that problem here. And, you know, we can change things, like, we can really dial in the audio system as well. Like, people might say, like, well, it's just a work truck. Well, considering how much time you spend in your work truck, you'll want, I think it's nice to have a decent sound system because it's a nice way to decompress and enjoy your drive because you're in the vehicle so much. Well, hopefully, guys, you like this quick little video of seeing what it's like to own a very high mileage work truck. And I think this is the way to go. If you were going to own a vehicle for a long period of time, especially when it's a work vehicle, this is how you get to start paying for itself, because a lot of owners will just change out a truck every 2 to 4 years. By owning this truck well over 800,000 kilometers, you know, do the math, a lot of entrepreneurs in this field will do about 50 to 60,000 kilometers a year. So if you can get this much mileage into a vehicle, you're going to save a lot of money because you're not purchasing another vehicle, because your maintenance stays the same. You're going to do the same amount of oil changes, you're going to buy the same amount of tires, and probably the same amount of fuel. I've seen so many mileage reports, and newer trucks don't really get much better mileage to offset the cost of an older truck. So the only way to really save money is to keep driving the same truck.